two, here. And to make sure that you hit the airstrip on the nose, we've assigned two Gurkha guys from the Burma Frontier Force to go with you. Karaho Gurkha. They don't speak English to any worthwhile degree, but they're extraordinarily familiar with the terrain and with the Burmese language. And I believe that you will find them excellent guides. That's all from me.
Thank you, Major. Well, the march from the radar station to the airstrip will be a forced march that shouldn't last over 11 hours at most. Now, here's the administration information. No musette bags, shelter halves, or toilet articles are to be taken. Each man will be issued 4D rations, 2K rations. You'll carry SOP ammunition loads. You'll take two 30-caliber machine guns, 1,000 rounds of ammo per gun. Each man will take 6 hand grenades. You'll carry SCR, 536 radios, 1 set of panels, 4 mirrors for signal communications.
That's about it.
Stations and HR will be announced later. You better hit the sack early and get some sleep. You're going to need it. And write your letters now. There's no mailing service where we're going. The chaplains of each faith will hold services in half an hour. Well, that's all, fellas. Dismiss. Well, you're Williams, aren't you? American News Service?
That's right, yes.
Nice to know you. My name's Nelson.
Can't know you.
The colonel said you were going to sit in on the briefing, but he didn't say why.
Well, I don't think exactly you'll fall on my neck and kiss me when you find out why, but the fact of the matter is, I'm going along with you. Oh. Yes, you see, GHQ said it was okay for one correspondent to accompany the mission. We drew lots for it, and I won, and here I am.
Well, if you got the authority, I can't stop you. But I think I ought to warn you. It's going to be tough, very tough.
Really? Well, it sounded to me just like a routine job.
Yeah? Not going to be routine, not even for the kids who are trained for it.
Well, I guess I can take it for a day or so.
All right. Let's go get your equipment. Look, Mr. Williams, it's your life, so I'll give it to you straight. This isn't a job for you. It's a young man's job.
Well, I'm not exactly decrepit.
No, maybe not. Do you know how old the colonel is in there?
No.
34. Do you know how old our commanding general is? 37. Young men, all of us. We've got to be. Do you know why? I'll give you two good reasons. We jump out of planes and guys shoot at us.
Yeah.
It isn't exactly healthy unless you're young enough to take it. Pardon my asking, but how old are you, Mr. Williams?
That's a military secret. Now, wait a minute. Let me tell you something. You know what I did before the war? I sat on a nice soft cushion in a pine-paneled office, and I gave orders, and people jumped, and I made a bugger of...